The point of this whole thing is that what people see in America is they see Friends, they love the show, it looks like a smooth running machine. But behind the scenes, there's deceit, mistrust, and hate. And I thought we'd actually take a look at, some of these moments where you guys are, there are mistakes. You make mistakes.
Oh, from time to time.
For example, I don't have to memorize lines. You guys actually have to remember what to say. And you probably forget from time to time, yes?
Our energy just comes way up when there's an audience here. And when that happens, something happens between your brain and your mouth sometimes, and it just doesn't work.
No, you didn't. I did.
So we realize. Oh no! I'm telling it.
Aha! Look, come on. I don't know what to do or say. Aha! Very funny. Look, I don't know what to do. You know? Holy. Ha ha ha, very funny. Look, I don't know what to do.
It's one of those days.
Scusa, signora. Vuole bere qualche...
Wow, Phoebe, you speak gutter?
You still get nervous, everybody, just before a show?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Every week. Yeah.
It's amazing, like, all week long we've been saying the same lines. And then the audience is here, and we will mess up. And if you mess up once, then you get nervous because you know you're going to probably mess up again.
Action.
When you were little, you slept through the Grand Canyon. This will be 5-10 takes.
Okay.
You know it's going to happen.
Once again, and action.
But when you were little, you slept through the Grand Canyon.
No one.
Okay. I'm going to try it without the coffee cup because I think it's the left hand that's messing me up.
That's it.
When you were little, you slept through the Grand... Sorry. Let's go back, because you've got more to say.
I do? That's a big problem. Yeah, that's your fault. I appreciate it. I love you.
I love you.
But there are a lot of moments over the years where you're just trying to do your job, something goes wrong.
Hey, and this is a little extra something for, you know, always being there for me.
Hey, Joey, the camera hit our wall.
That hurts.
You look at me.
Hey, Rachel.
Oh, yeah? Then how come I keep...
It was so wild. We told them that we were the Guttersons in room 6. I spit on her.
Operation, you had a fun one. With
Operation.
A little game. Yeah, with an electric buzzer in it.
Oh, and I brought Operation, but I lost the, it's making a noise.
But LeBlanc really doesn't mess up much.
You don't verbally mess up, but sometimes physically you mess up.
I've had clumsy moments, I guess you call it.
And we redid it, and he went back, and he was afraid he was going to fall down.
You can actually see him trying not to fall.
Peeps, check it out.
This particular time that he continued to fall or, you know, try not to fall, I was in the room with Matthew, and Matthew's like, should I do it?
Peeps, check it out.
Oh, soap opera digest.
Matthew, you have a reputation with the rest of the cast that sometimes you like to fool around a bit. You like to, if something's naturally going wrong, you like to get in there and juice it a little bit. True or false?
I don't necessarily like to juice things.
Said true or false?
Oh, whoa.
What are you doing?
You're still a tiny bit on fire there.
Oh, geez. Okay, thanks. Okay.
Great seeing you the other night.
Good to see you, too. Did you come down here to tell me that?
No. Came here to tell you something else. Came here
to tell you I still love you.
What the f*** are you doing?
Now, you guys work with animals a lot. You had to work early on with a monkey.
That damn monkey.
Okay, so now see the one with the feather boa? Now, that's Dr. Francis. She used to be a man. Oh, look, there. Okay. Katie, see, Katie, come here. Katie.
Come here, Katie.
Lisa's laugh, though, it's so infectious. It's one of those things, just forget about it. Once it starts, it's all gone. No, I don't want to switch. Come on. I can throw wet paper towels here.
Well, at Monica's, you can eat. Okay, she's that, yeah. Then, it's not silly.
Here we go.
Okay.
Yeah.
No. Ready?
Yeah.
And then it just builds on itself, and there's no doing the scene after. I mean, you have to probably wait and really get it together to do it.
For me, I have a hard time with LeBlanc in particular. When keeping a straight face, he delivers like this look or reaction to you or a certain take. I mean, it's so, I find it so funny.
Morning.
What kind of an actor can't even say, noodle soup?
We should go back because I take the other line.
Okay. I was filling more booze on there.
I think, subconsciously.
Oh, you lost me?
No, come on.
Okay, the next situation is for Rachel. The wedding is about to start. You walk into the back room and you find Monica taking a nap with Ross. I'll be Monica. Go.
No.
We'll be right back with more Friends, less me.
I'm doing my brother.
That's gross.
They always say, a performer should never work with pets or children.
Oh, the kids.
Action.
Okay. Now, what is my first line?
What did we agree?
Okay.
The good thing about the young kids is that they're completely unpredictable, which is a lot of fun as an actor to respond with, but there was one story the story was that I was anticipating that I would be around to hear my son's first words spoken, but the scene was about that he wasn't supposed to be able to speak, and for some reason when we started doing the show, hi, we're visiting.
Yay!
It's Ben and his dada. Can you say dada? You know, you might as well say it because I told
dada.
You can you say dada? See, I'm going to tell your mommies you said it anyway, so you might as well try.
Dada.
Huh?
Dada.
Yeah, he's saying dada. Yeah.
And then sometimes during the show, you know, there'll be like, the scene's going one way, but you're just tempted to say something another time. Like, do you remember that one where Monica's baking cookies?
She's trying to intrigue
apartment.
Us to hang out with her.
Yeah, she's trying to waft the smell across the hall to get us to come hang out in her new place. And we're sitting there eating pizza, and I think it was you that said,
what do I smell?
I think I was supposed to say, I don't know, I'd go over and open the door. I went,
what do I smell?
Sorry. And then it was like four takes later by the time we could get through to the street.
What do I smell? What do I smell?
I don't know. It smells good.
But audiences, you have a live studio audience, they must love that. They must love it when they see you guys playing.
you guys doing?
Nothing.
Nothing.
So they'll intentionally do something that they'll take it a step further in front of the audience. They'll intentionally screw it
up.
Yeah.
Why, what's the matter?
You've worn a fat suit on the show. And a lot of people love you in the fat suit. Do you like wearing the fat suit? Is it fun?
I'm melting!
They made me dance in the fat suit.
I heard some of you talking about this earlier, but sometimes there's just a word that somebody has to say that you'll get hung up on, and it'll just, the way you say the word is funny to everybody else.
That tastes like feet. It tastes like feet.
Sometimes the dialogue itself is just so funny, and we'll be rehearsing during the week, and you just, whatever the joke is, it's just so funny, we can't get through it in rehearsal, and you just mentally make a flag on it. You say, okay, show night, I'm just never going to be able to say this.
Are you saying that you don't want to get with this?
See, I don't say... She's pretty.
Oh, yeah, and she's really nice, too. She taught me all about, you know, how to work with the cameras and smell the fart acting.
Joey, I'm sorry.
What? When you have to do physical business for a scene, I mean, there must be a lot of funny moments when you actually physically have to do a task as part of the scene.
Yeah, Rachel Chandler and Ross had to try to get a couch up a very narrow New York stairwell. And that was probably, I think it's the hardest I've laughed in my life, period.
Pivot! Okay, pivot!
Done over 160 episodes, but like favorite moments that 80 years from now you'll be thinking about?
It was when we're able to crack each other up.
Monica's gonna have the phone in the right place!
We are fixing it. He's gone, he's waiting. We enjoy watching each other mess up or watching each other's performance. It's, you know, we like each other.
Oh, the band's ready. Well, we've got to do what the band says, and I don't care about the stupid band!
Okay, friends gang. Thanks for doing it.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, my babies.